What would you do if you were not afraid? Hey, this is me, Nivya, and today I'm going to speak about 5 books that are under 100 pages, which you cannot miss because they are so amazing books. Out of the 5 books, the first 3 books are going to be fictions and the last 2 are going to be non-fictions. Alright, now let's begin. The first book in my list is A Murder of Jayashekhar by Shalini P. Sarkar. This is the best, shortest suspense thriller I have ever read. I mean, it's just around 20 pages and so you can read it in maximum say 30 minutes and still you get great twists and turns and an amazing climax. As the book's title suggests, this is related to the murder of a person named Jayashekhar. I'm not sure if this author has written any more books or published any more books, but this one is definitely a clever writing and this book is going to keep you at the edge of your seat throughout the read. I couldn't find the hard copy or paperback of this book, but it's available in Kindle and that too in a very affordable rate, 21 rupees. So even if you do not have a Kindle device, what I would suggest you to do is go ahead and install the app Kindle in your mobile and download this book. You can read it easily in your mobile because it's just after all 20 pages. And I would suggest you not to read the briefing of this book in Goodreads or Amazon because that can give you a spoiler. Thankfully, I had not read the briefing and that helped me gain a great suspense out of this book. With that, let's go to the second book in my list. The second book in my list is Kutin's Dilemma by Lenny Varkey. Another great writing. Again, I'm not sure about this author as well, whether this author has written any more books, but where have you been? Both Shalini and Lenny, you guys are amazing writers. Anyway, so this book is a children's book which reminds you how significant trust between children and parents is. It's a mandatory read for parents. And it has a lot of pictures which makes you involved more into this book. And in just 35 pages, it let me travel to my childhood. It's an amazing book, very simple language and definitely a pick for both children, adults and anyone and everyone. Go ahead and pick this book up. With that, let's go to the third book in my list. The third book in my list is Gachar Gochar by Vivek Shanbhag. This is a Kannada book which was later translated to English. And I think out of all the books that I'm speaking about today, this is the longest one because it's around 100 pages. So this book is about a family who were poor initially and then later they became rich. And because of this transformation, how it affected their family, the relationship between the family members. The highlight of this book is a narration. And it's after reading the book that I realized that the first narrator's name is not mentioned in this entire book. I could not agree with all the points or thoughts of the protagonist in this book, but that's not important, right? Because not all the time the protagonist's thoughts should match with the reader's thoughts. So that's fine. And this book has an open ending. So if you are a person who do not like open endings, then this is definitely not a read for you guys. But if you like to think about, oh, what would have happened in the climax, as in what was that, then definitely this is your pick. With that, let's go to the next book in my list. Time for non-fictions, and the book is Why I'm an Atheist by Bhagat Singh. This is a short essay with a strong message to think about. Bhagat Singh clearly mentions why he was an atheist. And he presses a point that he was not an atheist because of his vanity. He clearly mentions that God was created by man when he realized his shortcomings, weakness, and limitations. He also mentions that instead of developing the ideas and experiments of the ancient thinkers, we still cling to the orthodox religions and this way reducing the human awakening to a stagnant pool. If you want to know more about this book, I've already made a video before. I'll share the link in the description box. Also, you'll see it right on top now. You can go ahead and see the video. I've given a lot more information about this book in that video. All right, with that, let's go to the last book in my list. Who Moved My Cheese by Spencer Johnson. A book which focuses on amazing ways to deal with change. in both your professional and personal life. So if you are a person stuck somewhere, if you're scared to try something new, if you want to basically try something new or bring a change in your life and still you're scared to do it, go ahead and read this book. It's highly motivational. This book is a non-fiction, but it has a fiction story inside. Like, there is a story about mice and miniature forms of people, but ultimately it's a non-fiction and it gives you a beautiful message. There are a lot of takeaways from this book, and I have made a video separately for this book. So if you want to know more about this book, you can check the video. I'll share the link in the description box. Basically, it's about upgrading yourself so that you don't become extinct. All right, so these were the 5 books that are under 100 pages, which I will definitely recommend you all to read. They're all so short, so go ahead and read them. They are not time consuming. You can finish it off so quickly and they are going to give you a lot of knowledge and messages. You will love them. All right, with that, this is Nivya signing off. Until we meet next time, bye, take care, happy reading, read a lot of books.